As most of you know, humans are primates. We belong to the same biological order that includes these snow monkeys. Because of this relationship, primates hold a special interest to us compared to other mammals. As we watch them exhibit their natural behavior, we see ourselves in the way they move and react to their surroundings. It is a unique treat to observe these animals. More than 150 snow monkeys live their lives, wild and natural, on nearly 200 acres of open savanna. But we're not where you might think, not in their home country of Japan, nor in Africa, where many associate seeing wild roaming primates. These monkeys and several hundred others reside in Dilley, Texas, about 80 miles south of San Antonio. They are permanent residents of the Born Free USA Primate Sanctuary, one of the most unique facilities of its kind, a place where primates can live as free as they can be. The sanctuary is home to more than 500 macaques, vervets, and baboons, many rescued from abusive or exploitative zoos, research labs, and private ownership. This refuge is unique, as it is one of the very few to provide a natural environment that meets the animal's physical and psychological needs, with a minimum of human contact. The first residents of the sanctuary were a group of snow monkeys who had been invading the suburbs of Kyoto, Japan, seeking food. The government was going to destroy them, so they needed to be relocated. A concerned American brought them to Texas.
They're original descendants from the Arashiyama troop that was shipped over from Japan in 1972. And these are all the descendants. And so they've been pretty much, they have been living free in this enclosure for quite some time. They've never been in a cage or in captivity, and nor have they been psychologically altered by humans or anything more than us feeding them. And because of that, we're able to walk inside the enclosure with these guys, and they're not going to bother us. They're not interested in us. They're not angry. They're not showing any stereotypic behavior. All they want is food from us, and we're happy to oblige.
These monkeys are the lucky ones. Many of the monkeys at the Born Free USA Sanctuary were formerly kept in small cages or held as private pets, utterly dependent on humans, never learning how to interact with their own kind. Before coming here, they had been severely deprived of their normal social structure and development. Over time, these highly intelligent social primates are rehabilitated so they can live out their lives with a high standard of care in small, semi-free ranging groups.
In terms of the expats, most of them come to us from a pet situation because the people have found that they don't make good pets. They turn violent, they become aggressive, they try to take over the household, they commonly bite and scratch their owner, and then the owner becomes fearful of them. They get placed in a small cage, and even though they're in a cage and the owner is somewhat in control, now you have a monkey that's even more upset than before, because now they lack freedom, and freedom's an important part of being a monkey. And it's typically at that point that we'll receive a call and a request for help. And that's what we want to be here for.
The sanctuary provides a safe, nurturing home in large enclosures designed to protect the monkeys while they learn to adapt to living with other primates.
No, this is Tamé. Now, she's an interesting story. She's a mess. So Tamé had spent 8 years as a pet. And unlike most primates who are kept as pets, she actually became very dependent upon the human and very social and what we would term as humans, very sweet. And she was brought to us at 8 years of age to try to get her to be more of a monkey. The owner realized that she could have a better quality of life if she had more space, more things to do, and could be a monkey. But unfortunately, Tamé's had a very, very long adjustment period. She's still largely dependent upon human interaction. And we generally don't provide a lot of human interaction unless they require it. Obviously, if they require it, we're going to provide some. We have to assist them in a rehabilitation process, getting over some of their human socializations. Some of these monkeys turn their back on us and go straight to being into monkeydom within a month, and others may take several years. But at least, fortunately, finally, Tamé's on the road.
The enclosures allow residents to live in a safe, stimulating environment with the maximum amount of privacy.
Well, these are baboons, and these are particularly Hamadryas here. And these baboons have come from expat situations as well as from some of these animals were utilized in laboratories. And so what we do here, like all the primates at Born Free USA Primate Sanctuary, is give them as natural of a life as possible. And so we've provided this 2.5 acre lush environment for them, and they get to, again, just be baboons. And what we'd like to do here is we'd like to put cinder block buildings on the end of these enclosures and be able to propane heat them in the winter. We don't get a lot of cold weather here, but when it does come, it's really uncomfortable for the baboons. They are really sun-loving animals. The total of building 3 of these brick houses would run about $30,000, but would make a significant difference to these guys. This enclosure is what we call a semi-natural enclosure, and it's about 1/4 acre in size total, divided into 2. We have 7 monkeys representing 5 different species, and they've all been able to get along. They've all adapted to each other. They know each other. They have their little tiffs, but no injuries occur, and they have each other to groom and socialize with and play with, and that's what we like to see. And it's probably about as good as it's going to get socially for these guys. They'll never be able to be released out into the main troop of monkeys that we have, the wild-reared ones. But what we would like for these guys is to have a much larger enclosure. We want them to have natural trees in their enclosure and a much larger space to play in. And so those enclosures are probably going to be about 1/4 to 1/2 acre in size and going to run anywhere from $25,000 to $50,000. And that's what we want to do. We have almost 60 monkeys here in these semi-natural enclosures that eventually we want to move into larger spaces. These enclosures serve a great purpose because they allow us kind of a controlled environment to introduce these monkeys to each other, give them time to socialize, integrate, and figure out who they are and who they want to be with each other. But once that occurs, then we would like to see them in even a bigger space. And so that's the direction we want to go with these guys, is we want to take the next leap and open up a big room for them. And of course, foundations and private support can help us accomplish that.
You can be part of Born Free USA's effort to give these rescued individuals a second chance. It's easy to help by making a donation or by participating in our Sanctuary Primate Adoption Program. For just $1 a week, you'll support one of the adoptees, making a crucial difference to their well-being. Or you can make a donation that will help us build new spacious enclosures for animals in need, add climbing and play structures to our current areas, and cinder block houses to help give primates some added shelter from the elements, or participate in the Go Nuts or Go Bananas programs, fun ways to provide welcome treats to the animals in our care and provide a unique gift to one of your friends or family members. Managing a large sanctuary is not only extremely expensive, it's also a long-term commitment, as many of our primates live up to 30 years. We are responsible for them 365 days a year. We count on compassionate people, such as you, to partner with us. Find out more about how you can help the Born Free USA Primate Sanctuary residents by visiting our website, bornfreeusa.org/sanctuary, or email us at primates@bornfreeusa.org.
Obviously, what we'd like to see is for people to become better educated about the situation as a whole, about all the bad things that happen when you keep these animals and pets. And we're hopeful that eventually people will start realizing that wildlife belongs in the wild, not in the home, not in a zoo, and not in a research facility.